Good evening and welcome to this edition of News Leader on 6. I'm Jim Fuller.
And I'm Amelia Marquez. In tonight's news, State Representative Judd Matheny has submitted legislation which would increase penalties for individuals who kill or injure someone while fleeing police officers. And the Tullahoma City School Superintendent is being considered for a similar job in Mississippi. We'll have these stories and more on tonight's News Leader on 6.
When your family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
Welcome back. State Representative Judd Matheny of Tullahoma has sponsored legislation identified as the Joe Moon Act, which would substantially increase penalties for motor vehicle drivers who kill or injure someone while attempting to escape police officers. Tullahoma resident Joe Moon was killed in a traffic accident last year when his truck was struck by a 21-year-old McMinnville woman who was fleeing Coffee County deputies after being stopped for a traffic violation in Manchester. The impact of the crash caused Moon's vehicle to roll over and burst into flames. Joe Moon worked for the city of Tullahoma for over 40 years and had recently retired when the accident occurred. Representative Matheny said, quote, "I hope this bill ends up being a deterrent to this ever happening again," end quote. Matheny's proposed legislation would escalate the penalty for this crime to a Class C felony. The bill was approved by House Subcommittee on Tuesday and will now be considered by the full committee.
The Tullahoma News reported in this week's Wednesday edition that Tullahoma City School Superintendent Dr. Dan Lawson is one of the three finalists for the school superintendent's job in Starksville, Mississippi. Dr. Lawson notified the Tullahoma School Board last Friday that he was under consideration for the job. Dr. Lawson told the Tullahoma News that it was too early in the process to speculate on the potential new hires for the job he currently holds in Tullahoma.
Tullahoma Fire Chief Richard Chastain presented a certificate of recognition to Don Young Monday night at the Tullahoma Board of Mayor and Alderman meeting. Mr. Young recently helped save a Tullahoma family after their home caught fire.
I would like to introduce a good friend of Tullahoma, Mr. Don Taylor. Mr. Young, as you know, does a lot of walking. We had a walk across Tennessee that the mayor organized with the help of Winston Brooks. And how many miles did you walk, Mr. Young? You remember?
820
miles. Back and forth to Manchester a couple of times, and I've passed him since then, heading to Manchester walking. So I know he wasn't just doing it for show. He means it when he does it. And recently, we were having a nice Friday about lunchtime, and I was at City Hall, and everything was going smooth, and all of a sudden we got a structure fire page on Anderson Street. And so, of course, we headed that way. When I arrived, Mr. Young was there. He had noticed the fire while he was walking down the road. There were cars passing both ways. That road has thousands of cars a day, and Mr. Young noticed it. And he didn't just notice it and keep walking. He took action. He alerted people. Actually, these people were in the home asleep. Mm-hmm. And he knocked on the door, alerted them, got them up, made them aware of what was going on. The unique situation was the fire was in the attic. So no smoke alarms had sounded, but it was a pretty serious fire. I feel like in a matter of a few more minutes, the ceiling would have collapsed because the fire was above the ceiling and some wiring and burning large wood objects in the attic. We don't know what would have happened, but we know what could have happened. So we just wanted to take an opportunity to thank Mr. Young for being willing to get involved and to help his fellow man.
Great.
Yeah, there were three people in that house that were very appreciative that he let them know. And I'm going to tell you, when I pulled up, there wasn't much smoke, to be honest with you. I might have driven by. But he was very alert and took action. We really appreciate it. This is a certificate of recognition presented to Don Young for your keen sense of recognizing a potentially dangerous smoke situation in a home and having the willingness to get involved, therefore helping to save the lives of three unsuspecting fellow citizens. We thank you for your outstanding efforts. And it's signed by myself and the mayor. So, thank you.
We'll be back in a moment with more News Leader on 6.
Tax time is here and it's the perfect time to buy a vehicle, but you're not sure where to go because of poor credit help? Come see me, Dr. Credit, and the rest of the team here at Russell Barnett Kia. But don't take it from me. Here's a few of our satisfied customers and what they had to say.
He did everything and anything he could possibly do to help me.
Dr. Credit was very helpful in getting me a vehicle that I could afford.
Everything he explained to us was amazing. I would recommend him to anybody and everybody.
Dr. Credit helped very, very much.
Schedule your appointment with Dr. Credit at Russell Barnett Kia so you can drive away happy.
Welcome back. Opioid addiction is on the rise among young adults in Tennessee. Tom Corrington spoke recently with Judy Jenkins, a retired registered nurse who lost a daughter to opioid addiction. Tonight we bring you part one of that interview.
We have a serious and dangerous, really, public health issue staring the whole country in the face, and that is the what's now dubbed the opioid epidemic. And fortunately, we're becoming more and more aware of this, and that's our purpose here today, is to increase your awareness and understanding, education a little bit, if you will. Our guest is Judy Jenkins. Judy is a retired nurse. She is volunteering. She's a volunteer extraordinaire. She does lots of volunteering, including appearing with us, to try to get the information out there for raise people's awareness. And Judy has not only personal experience, but also a family tragedy involved in this issue. And maybe she'll tell us a little bit about that. So welcome, Judy. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. It's my privilege to be here.
And what can you tell us about the personal tragedy?
I was the mother of five beautiful children. I am now the mother of four. I had a 41-year-old daughter who died unnecessarily from a drug overdose. It was an accidental drug overdose. But the bottom line is she's gone and I've lost her. The double tragedy for me was that I'm a registered nurse and I have spent my career trying to educate people about drugs and their negative effects and trying to make sure that other nurses in the hospital that I worked at evaluated each patient fairly, because you can't refer to a patient as a druggie. They are a person, and frequently we call them other things. So I lost a child unnecessarily. I hope to be able to make the statement one day, no one else will ever lose a child to this problem, because it is an epidemic.
Let's begin, Judy, by make sure we understand what we're talking about when we say opioid epidemic. What is that?
Well, an opioid is another name for it, is a narcotic. Frequently people just call them street drugs, but what has created the epidemic is not so much the street drugs that we've been dealing with for hundreds of years, heroin, cocaine, meth, but we have now observed that we have crossed over and we're now using prescription medications inappropriately. Now, there's a difference between using a medicine correctly and using it in an abusive way. If you use it correctly, your doctor has prescribed it. The minute that the pain has gone away, you don't use the medicine anymore. You have the bottle, you tuck it away in your medicine cabinet. Abuse occurs when a person who does not have pain, or who first had pain, got it cleared up, but continues with the use of the medicine, because sometimes not for pain anymore, but they've taken it and it gives them a different feeling that is pleasurable, or they feel that they are behaviorally different after they take it. So they continue taking it. At that point, very easily it becomes a disease. opioid abuse is a disease just like alcoholism, heart disease, you know, bad circulation disease. The problem is a disease that becomes chronic and continues. And it's very hard to break the cycle if you're not aware of it and obviously have help.
Yeah, well, you know, socially, it's not been acceptable to talk about
Absolutely. Drug
abuse. That's been the history of things, and we're now Right. Finally, hopefully, facing up to the fact that we are talking about a disease, a mental health disease, just like any other.
Right.
And so we should take the stigma away from it.
Absolutely.
And get it out on the table so
Absolutely.
We know what we're
talking
dealing
about
with.
The problem is the only way that you raise awareness. And after you've raised awareness, then the next phase is action. You have to develop a plan or be prepared to do some pretty dramatic things.
More News Leader on 6 is coming up after these messages.
It's not invoice. It's not MSRP. It's not Christmas Day, although it may feel like it. It's the lowest prices in Middle Tennessee, period. Get to Stan McNabb Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram or Stan McNabb Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac before these prices are gone forever.
All right, the cat's out of the bag at Carroll Street Liquor in Tullahoma. Now you know where to go if you're planning a get-together and want the ideal wine or spirit. Party planning can be stressful, but at Carroll Street Liquor, you'll find everything you need. Mixers, gift sets, and all of your favorite spirit brands. So if you're feeling the pressure to pull off the ideal party, come to Carroll Street Liquor and select among the seemingly endless supply of wines, spirits, gift sets, and more. Your perfect party, it's in the bag with Carroll Street Liquors.
Welcome back. Tullahoma Middle School and High School archery coach Josh Harris stopped by Monday's Tullahoma Board of Mayor and Alderman meeting and brought along some of his award-winning archery team.
You know, we've got some outstanding athletes in Tullahoma. You would agree, Mr. Mathis?
I really do.
And some of those athletes maybe don't get the publicity that some other athletes do, but I'm very pleased to recognize Mr. Josh Harris. Could you step to the podium, please, sir? And tell us a little bit about your team and how well they've been doing, and we'll introduce each of those also, please.
All right. Basically, what I do is I'm a coach for the middle school and high school students. The organization that we're with is called Scholastic 3DA. It just started a couple years ago here in Tennessee. And I've been coaching archery for probably 5 or 6 years. And we didn't really have something to participate in that fit, you know, my archers. So basically, when I found out about Scholastic 3DA, we dove into it, and we went to participate in the state indoor tournament this year, which is the first year they've done this indoor state. And I had four kids I took down there, and out of those four, all four of them placed. So I'm going to first introduce Jackson McKelvey. He's a high school student that placed first in the state and also won the $20,000 scholarship to Bethel University.
Wow.
And he was basically the only high school student that went. So I know he's a little bit nervous. I did have three middle school people that attend. First, I'm going to recognize Slade Raposa. He won first place in the state in fixed pin division. And then I had two females I took with me. Natalie Best, she got second place in the fixed pin division. And then also I took Olivia Allar. She didn't receive reward, but we looked at the total points. She got fourth place. Olivia. And then now we got the indoor nationals to attend, which is also gonna be in Cincinnati, Ohio, March 17th. And then after the indoor season's over with, we begin our 3D season. So we got that to look forward to. So hopefully we win state and win another $20,000 scholarship.
So I'd like for each of the young people maybe to introduce themselves and tell us why they maybe enjoy archery. Or Jackson, we'll start with you.
Well, I kind of grew up and I just kind of enjoyed the outdoors and everything. And then I heard Mr. Harrison this probably when I was in middle school when I started it. And like I said, he never really had like an organization going on with it. And I had to stay with it, and then we heard about the classics. And then so we went into that, and then won state.
So what is there about archery why do you excel at archery? What's the key to your success?
Well, I don't really know. I just enjoy being outdoors and everything, so I just went from there. And then Mr. Harris, he coached me a lot, so I do a lot of credit to Mr. Harris.
You must have extraordinary hand-eye coordination, I would think, to be able to do that.
So what did you shoot at the state?
Sir?
What was your score at the state?
I shot a 146 out of 150.
Out of 150?
Yes, sir.
And you
have
most X's.
Yes.
Wow.
Are you going to go to Bethel?
I don't know. I haven't toured it or anything. So
it's in McKenzie, Tennessee. That's the home of my parents. My mom was a cheerleader at Bethel College back in the day.
Yeah.
Might want to go.
Yeah, I got to go up there and look at it.
So you earned a $20,000 scholarship.
Yes, sir.
Only to Bethel or?
No, it's only to Bethel.
Only two. Okay. All right. Good.
What distance do you shoot the arrow?
Well, at the indoor, it was only 20 yards. So.
Well, congratulations.
Thank you.
Excellent job. All right, young man, tell us a little bit about yourself.
This is Slaver Poser.
What was your score?
136.
Wow. Okay. Very good.
What age group?
12-year-old.
12-year-old?
Middle school.
Gotcha.
How long have you been doing?
About 3 years.
Very impressive.
That's good.
So I guess how many more years are you in the middle school level?
I'm in seventh grade now, so one more year.
Yeah. Good. Well, thank you for being here tonight.
Yes, sir.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right, ladies.
I will recall he did shoot 140s consistently in practice until we got to the state and got shot a 136, but still got first place.
Yeah.
Next will be Natalie Best. She got third place.
For the tournament, I got 100 points with 8 X's, and I'm really excited about going to the Nationals in Ohio.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't have done it without my team been there to support me and help me to become a better shooter.
Yeah. What is there about archery that appeals to you?
I don't really know. I don't like killing animals. I don't like to injure animals, but I just shoot for the fun of it.
Sure. But it doesn't bother you to shoot at a target, I guess.
No, sir.
Good. Very impressive.
Thank you.
This is Olivia Allard. She, like I said, she got fourth place at the middle school fixed pin division.
I was really excited and nervous at the same time. I mean, I wasn't really thinking that we would be serious about it at first when I first started last year. But the more I get into it, I've learned that we know how to work together and we know when to be serious and when we can have fun and play around. At the tournament, I scored a 96.
Wow, congratulations, yeah.
And what grade are you in?
Seventh.
How many of you can beat Mr. Harris shooting a bow?
Probably only Slade and Jackson. Okay. They have the best chance of it.
Are those your archery class shirts? Or?
Yes, sir.
I think those are good looking.
Those are competition jerseys.
Thank you.
Well, very good. We congratulate each of you on representing our community well and wish you much success in the future. Look forward to big things from each of you. And we're very pleased to recognize the archery. And Mr. Harris, thanks to you and your coaching. So thank you. We have a good
We'll be right back in just a moment.
All I have to do to think about what I was physically before and what I am now, and I don't ever want to go back to that original situation.
The overall mission of the rehab team is always what is best for the patient and how we can facilitate maximum potential from every resident.
Well, the most important thing to me is that I'm allowed to do whatever I want to do, you know.
Everyday miracles at Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
We're losing it, doctor.
Not on my shift quickly. Brush. Roller.
What a transformation.
It's going to be okay.
Okay, nothing.
At Paintworks of Tullahoma, we specialize in domestic emergencies with Martin Senior paints. You can be the paint doctor, too, when you treat your home with Martin Senior interior and exterior finishes.
Doctor, we've got another one.
Got you covered.
Paintworks of Tullahoma. Come see the paint doctor, stat.
Welcome back. Carbon monoxide is a colorless, odorless, tasteless gas produced by burning gas, wood, propane, charcoal, or other fuels. Improperly ventilated appliances and engines, particularly in tightly sealed or enclosed space, may allow carbon monoxide to accumulate in dangerous levels. Let's watch this video to see how we can protect ourselves from injury or death from carbon monoxide.
Safety tips to prevent carbon monoxide poisoning. Generators should be operated in well-ventilated locations outdoors, at least 3 feet away from all doors, windows, vent openings, and combustibles. Install carbon monoxide alarms inside your home to provide early warning of the buildup of this deadly gas. Look for the Underwriters Laboratories or UL certification when buying an alarm. Read the manufacturer's recommendations for the proper placement of the carbon monoxide alarm. Call your local fire department's non-emergency number to find out what number to call if the carbon monoxide alarm sounds. Post that number by your telephone. Make sure everyone in the household knows the difference between the fire emergency and carbon monoxide emergency numbers, if there is a difference. Test carbon monoxide alarms at least once a month and replace the batteries according to the manufacturer's instructions. A carbon monoxide alarm is not a substitute for a smoke alarm. Use both a carbon monoxide alarm and a smoke alarm. The cause of the carbon monoxide poisoning was found to be people improperly using a charcoal grill indoors for cooking and heating, running a generator indoors, or running a vehicle in a closed garage. The normal use of propane and natural gas appliances or kerosene heaters does not cause carbon monoxide poisoning with proper ventilation. But in poorly ventilated or enclosed spaces, carbon monoxide can build to dangerous levels, causing poisoning when the fumes are inhaled. It is never safe to use a charcoal grill hibachi inside the home. Why is carbon monoxide so dangerous?
This gas has no color, taste, or odor to it, so it's very difficult to realize when you're breathing it in.
The effects of carbon monoxide poisoning.
The effects of carbon monoxide can be variable. They can be mild, like dizziness, nausea, vomiting. They can be severe, as in coma, unconsciousness, or even death.
The role of a hyperbaric chamber.
Treatment in a hyperbaric oxygen chamber is critical to severe cases of carbon monoxide poisoning. It removes the carbon monoxide molecule from the red blood cells rapidly and eliminates the toxic effects.
What to do if carbon monoxide poisoning is suspected? If you suspect carbon monoxide poisoning, get out into the fresh air immediately. Do not stop to gather belongings or pack clothes. Simply get everyone together and get out into the fresh air. Do not leave your door open. Always close the door behind you. The fire department can then test and detect for a possible leak. If you or your loved ones are experiencing the symptoms of carbon monoxide poisoning, contact your doctor immediately or go directly to the hospital and get yourself and your loved ones checked for possible carbon monoxide poisoning. Remember, you cannot see or smell carbon monoxide, but it can be deadly. Follow these simple steps to protect yourself and your loved ones from this silent killer.
The pet of the week this week at the Tullahoma Animal Shelter is a Border Collie mix named Spanky. He entered the shelter as a stray and is approximately 6 months old. Spanky is up to date on his vaccinations, heartworm negative, and good with other dogs and children. He will receive a free neuter provided by the animal shelter. Be sure to check out the shelter on Facebook for information about upcoming events and fundraisers. Remember, you can help support your local shelter by adopting, donating, or volunteering. For more details, contact Teresa at 454-9580. The Tullahoma Animal Shelter is located at 942 Maplewood Avenue.
The Coffee County Humane Society feature pet this week is Daisy. She is a lab mixed dog who needs a forever home. The shelter also has many other dogs available for adoption at 1210 Oakdale Street in Manchester. Hours of operation at the shelter are 7:30 a.m. until 2:30 p.m. Monday through Friday. The shelter's phone number is 723-2730. Donations for animal care can be made to the Coffee County Humane Society at P.O. Box 252 in Manchester. Their website is www.coffeehumane.org. Stay with us. Your weather forecast is coming up after these messages.
Trucks, trucks, and more trucks. Keith Barnett here with the Russell Barnett Automotive Family, and we have your next truck. From the Ford F-Series, the Ram, Chevrolet, or the GMC, then look no further than the Russell Barnett family. With over 350 new and pre-owned trucks to choose from, now is the time to buy. Stop by one of our five locations. That's Russell Barnett Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram, Chevrolet GMC, Ford of Winchester, and Russell Barnett Ford and Kia of Tullahoma, or visit us on the web at russellbarnett.com. Why buy anywhere else?
Welcome back. We'll take a look at your weather forecast at this time, starting with your weather history on this day. Our record high was in 1932 at 78 degrees. The record low was in 1980 at 9 degrees. The average high on this day is 58 and the average low is 35. Mostly clear weather expected tonight with a low of around 32. Mostly sunny weather in the forecast for Friday with a high of 46 and a low of 32. Mostly sunny weather expected again on Saturday with a high of 56 and a low of 42. And we want to remind everybody that this Saturday from 10 to 2 at Tullahoma High School, Russell Barnett will be conducting a fundraiser drive for your school. They will. All you got to do is go out there and take a test drive in one of their Ford products, and they will. Ford Motor Company will donate up to $6,000 maximum to the Tullahoma High School project graduation. And so the more people that actually go out there and do this, it's a fun event and you get a chance to try out some new cars. It's a great event, and you could help the Tullahoma High School project graduation raise up to $6,000. 10 to 2 this coming Saturday.
Absolutely. And from all of us on News Leader 6, wishes you and your families a fantastic weekend. Thank you.